Hey guys, it's Christy and welcome back. Today I'm going to do a collective haul. This is from Black Friday on. So I've got quite a bit and it truly is collective. You're going to see stuff from Macy's, Ulta, Sephora, Meijer, and Rite Aid. I think that's all of them. First, I want to show you my lip combo, which I'm loving. I know I got this acne thing going on around my face, but let's pretend like that's not there. And I'm going to show you what I am just loving. It's this Cherries in the Snow from Revlon. It's $4.40, and that's what it looks like. And it's just a really pretty red, kind of like a berry red. And over it, I've been using this Dior Addict Ultra Gloss in Flash number 856. And I just think it's really, really pretty. Put some more. Could never have too much gloss. So let me know what you guys think of it. I'm into a red lip right now, so that's my thing. We all got to have our thing now, don't we? So anyway, let me know what you guys think of that. That's probably going to show up in my favorites, but I just wanted to share it because I think it's so pretty, especially for the Christmas time. I will go ahead and get started putting stuff together. I wanted to say thank you to everyone who sent Christmas cards to Dalton Dingus. It does look like he hit the level of cards that he needed, but he has set a new goal, and he's asking people to still send cards because he wants to get enough cards where no one can ever beat his record. And if you haven't watched the video that I posted about him, I'll link it below. The short story of it is he's a 9-year-old from Sayersville, Kentucky. He has stage 4 cystic fibrosis. About 3 weeks ago, they sent him home with, I think it was 2 to 8 days to live. So, he's on antibiotics, according to, you know, according to newspaper articles that I've read. And it's something for him to look forward to every day. So, please, if you could, just send him a card. And his address and everything is in my video, but I wanted to let you guys know that he did hit the number of cards that he needed to get in the Guinness Book of World Records. So thank you so much to everyone who sent those cards. We'll go ahead and get started with what I got on Black Friday. I usually go Black Friday shopping with family. This year I didn't go. I was tired. My cousin, my aunt, my other cousin, her daughter wanted me to come. It would take me about 2 hours to get to where they were Black Friday shopping. And my family's like me. When they're shopping. And I didn't know if I could hang this one particular time. I was pretty tired. So I didn't go. My husband felt sorry for me, so he took me Black Friday shopping here. And I will show you what I got. He took me to Ulta. I didn't get anything there. But I did get some of the $10 deals at Sephora. So I wanted to show you those. One of the things that I got was the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. And it's just a small version of the bronzer. And it came with this little brush, which I'll probably never use for anything. It's really, really small, but it's cute. And then the bronzer smells like chocolate. And this is just a small travel size. It does have a mirror. It's a matte bronzer, and that's what it looks like. The next thing I got was this Art of Shaving kit. This was $10. It has the pre-shave oil, the shaving cream, the brush, and the aftershave balm, which would be good for my husband for travel. And then I didn't get the Buxom set. I wanted it, but it was sold out by the time that I was actually able to get a parking spot because we drove around for 45 minutes at the mall trying to get a parking spot. Bless our hearts. So, that was sold out, but I was able to get the Stila Merry and Bright palette, which was $10. There's a mirror. Well, I'll just pull it back. You'll be able to see it. It's got 6 eyeshadows. They're neutral, and it also has a cream product at the bottom that is, it's a dual-use product. It's a cream blush, and it's also a lipstick. With that came the Stila Kitten lip glaze. I haven't opened it yet, but it's just a regular lip glaze. It still has this thing on the end. That's a brush tip applicator, and it's kind of like a beige lip gloss with a shine to it, with a sparkle to it. Not glitter, just kind of a sheen. I'll go ahead and start getting the rest of my stuff out. I've had the craziest week, let me tell you. Livy, which is my oldest cat, she started getting a limp, and my husband noticed it, and I called the vet, and the vet said, watch her for a couple days. If she's still limping, bring her in. So I brought her in. She was still limping. And she's okay. They did x-rays and all that kind of stuff, and she just pulled a muscle. But anyway, when we were in there, as you guys know, my cats are kind of vocal. So the doctor, well, the vet, he was watching her walk, and she was kind of walking away from him, and he looked at me, and he said, is she licking her paw or anything? At the very same time that I said no, Libby turns around and looks at him and goes, meow, like, me? I would never. So I kind of started laughing. He said, well, he said, I guess I don't have to talk to you anymore. It looks like she can answer for herself. I said, yeah, she doesn't care to speak up. And he said, I always wanted to be like Dr. Doolittle. And I was like, well, what do you know? Today is your lucky day. So they enjoyed Libby at the vet. And they said she was good in the back when she did the x-rays. I don't believe them. I think they lied. I mean, I didn't hear her scream or anything, but I just can't imagine Libby laying on her back letting them take x-rays and not just being grouchy. But they said that she was just fantastic. So maybe that's the way it is. She just mean for me and good for everybody else. I don't know. But anyway, the thing with Libby is since she has a pulled muscle, my husband and I are supposed to, we're not supposed to cage her or anything like that. She's allowed to run free, but we're supposed to help her. So if she jumps or whatever, we're supposed to pick her up and help her down, all this kind of stuff. So that basically means that we're following her around at all waking hours trying to keep her from jumping, which she is finding, she at first was finding fun, and she would act like, you know, she needed help with everything. And now she's running, trying to get away from us so that she can jump, you know, on purpose. And then at other times, we see her and she's walking fine, and then just as soon as she sees you, she'll start holding her paw up and limping like she's dying, and then she wants a treat. So I don't know, she's rotten. Okay, what do we have? I went back to Rite Aid. Shit, that door is locked. I went back to Rite Aid. And, you know, they had that buy one, get one half off deal. Well, I got the blush in, this is the powder palette multicolor blush from Physicians Formula in Blushing Berry. So I got that. It's just a really pretty kind of light berry color. And then I also got the Physicians Formula Vegas Strips. And this came, this is a light bronzer, but I'm going to use it as a highlighter. This came in a pack with these two little cream eyeliners. One's black, one's brown. And this little brush. So I got those. Then I went to, not on the same day, but I went to Meijer, and they've got that Rimmel stuff on sale, and I like Rimmel lipsticks, and I like their eye makeup remover, but you know, I just got a blush the other day, and that was in Autumn Catwalk or something like that. Well, anyway, I hauled it. I like the blush, long and short of that story. And I was in Meijer, and they had on clearance for 50% off. So the blushes were $2.24. So I picked up three. This one is in Berry, which looks more like a, it honestly looks more like a bronzer in the pan from what I can tell. But who knows when you swatch it. This one is in Spring Flower, and it's kind of broken a little bit up here, but for $2, I didn't really care that it, you know, had a little spot in it. It's not a big deal. And it's kind of got three different bronzy looking colors, and I've been wanting to try that one. And then I got Tickle Me Pink. So I'm interested to try those. I really like the one that I tried. And you can't beat that price. I mean, even at $5 a blush, that's a good price. I went to Macy's. I'm not big into Clarins. I've never, I don't know why. It's just never been something that just kind of struck my fancy. It's just, I've never had a bad experience with Clarins. I've never had enough experience with Clarins to even really know one way or another. But anyway, I saw the picture for, you know, their winter release or their fall release. I can't remember. But anyway, I really liked the girls' lip combination. So I found out what it was, and it's actually permanent. It's not anything that's special to that collection. And what she had on was a gloss in number 01 chocolate. And this is so pretty. And I really like this gloss. It is like a, it's a brown, but it's got a berry undertone to it. And it's so pretty, and I just love it. And it has kind of a fruity scent. And it's not ultra sticky or anything like that. So I may start really kind of looking more into the Clarins brand because I really like that gloss. Now, the lipstick I did not get. I got a lipstick from Ulta. And this is the lipstick that I got. Now, they had a gloss, I think it was called Deep Chocolate, not a gloss, a lipstick called Deep Chocolate. But I didn't want to spend $24 on it because when I swatched it on my hand and stuff and I swatched the gloss over it, it didn't really seem to make a whole lot of difference because the gloss in and of itself is pretty opaque. So I picked this up at Ulta. This is the one of the L'Oreal Colorish lipsticks in 182. And this is what it looks like. It's satiny cocoa. And it goes really pretty. It's just that light brownish berry kind of, just a hint of berry, not a lot. It's more brown than anything. But these are a little bit expensive for drugstore. They're like $10, but if you get that coupon that's like $3.50 off a $10 purchase, then I think, that's a lot better. Believe it or not, it was buy one get one half off, and I did not get one half off because I'm trying to stop that. As you guys know, I have a tendency if it's buy one get one half off, I get two. So even if I'm not really wanting the one, which isn't really a good way to go. But they also, I had been looking for this Zoya nail polish in Storm, and it's a black with multicolored glitter in it. Well, I can't find it anywhere. But what I did find was this World Away, and this is by China Glaze, and this is one of their Cirque du Soleil polishes, and it has white hexagons, and then it has black. It looks like a caramel apple, and that's the best way I can describe it. It's a stick with a ball on the end is what the black ones are, but it's not a black polish. It's clear. So that's gonna be fun to play with, I think. That's what it looks like. And I picked that up at Ulta, and then I got a couple things at Sephora. Sephora. Did I just get something on my face? I do that in every video. Did I just get something on my face? I got that $20 off coupon, so I got two NARS blushes. The first one I got is in Madly, and it's just kind of a peachy color. It doesn't look like much in the pan. That's what it looks like on my finger. It's just a really natural kind of cheek color, something that you're going to put with, it would actually went well with what I have on today. It pretty much goes with everything. The other one that I got was Taos, and Taos is a berry color with a golden sheen, and that's what it looks like. And then I got a lip gloss, NARS lip gloss in Dolce Vita, and although I like the color of the lip gloss, it's unlike my other NARS lip glosses in that when I go to put it on, it seems like I get halfway across my lip and I run out of product, which is really weird. So I don't know if this one is just an old one or what's going on. They smell kind of plasticky. The last thing I got, and this was actually, I got this on Black Friday. This was from Macy's too. Were two things from MAC. And these, God, I wish I remembered the, it won't even say on the outside of it. Nope. These are from one of their latest collections. MAC is wearing me out with all these collections, driving me absolutely bonkers. But anyway, I just, from this last collection they released, which I can't think of the name of, I picked up two things. I picked up one of their Matine lipsticks and one of their lip glosses. The lipstick I picked up was in Nocturnal Instincts. And this is kind of, it sort of actually reminds me of NARS packaging a little bit because it has sort of that rubbery kind of feel to it. It's different. That's, I guess, the best way to describe it. It's hard to describe. It's not as rubbery as NARS, but it's getting close. But it's really sleek. And that's what the lipstick looks like. And it's just a really pretty kind of berry with purple undertone. And the lip gloss that I got to go with that, is this, and it's a really pretty shimmering purple. And it just, oh, I caught it with my leg. That was nice. At least it didn't hit the floor. This is Perky. That's what it looks like, and it's just really pretty. And I think it looks really pretty over that lipstick. I guess I could put that up here so you can see what Perky looks like beside of it. I guess I would call it a lilac. But anyway, that is what I've hauled lately. I hope you guys are having an awesome week, and I hope you're not chasing after cats. And don't forget to comment and subscribe if you haven't subscribed. If you have subscribed, I'm tickled to death to have you. I've got a few new subscribers, and you never really know what I'm gonna say or do, I guess. But anyway, just whatever comes to my head. But I will talk to you guys later. I'm starving to death, so I gotta go get something to eat. Have a good weekend. Bye.